Surgery today is a very evolving market. Although it has got a very different dimension in terms of business and capital intensity. So in today's session, we have many experts who have individual refractive practices experience with the government setup and as well as the institutional setup. They are going to share their experiences. So to begin with, I'll talk about the venturing into refractive practice, actually. So most of the ophthalmologists, we are routine cataract surgeons. We are doing general ophthalmology. And a time comes where you think of switching over to refractive surgery. Because even a cataract surgery or normal surgery has become a refractive surgery. Now patient wants 6-6 and patient want a good vision, quality of vision. So why we think of doing the refractive surgery? Are we following any data? Are we looking into a market? So many times theory, the literature shows these kind of myopia and refractive error existing in the market, percentage of that market, then a percentage of myopia, hyperopia belonging to certain age group. And that sometimes motivates us to think of refractive surgery because it's a safe science nowadays. So question comes to mind, should I enter into refractive practice? Second is, do we have sufficient resources to cater that? Should I invest alone or in the group? We are going to cover all these points through all the speakers. Will I earn from the refractive practice or will it be a liability on my head? Because we come across many centers. So you require good experience about the clinical practice as well as the investment. It being a capital intensive, this machine requires a lot of maintenance and a lot of investment along with the recurring cost also, as Vardhaman rightly said. So if you are thinking in terms of earning from refractive practices, you have to keep certain things in your mind. Should I enter into refractive practice? Like I am solely into refractive practice. So if you love refractive surgery, then no doubt all the questions are irrelevant. You just enter into refractive market, study well and get into it. But if you have an ambition, you are a successful cataract surgeon and you have an ambition to cater to the community, or if you feel ki, yes, you have to provide all the facilities to your patient, you have to be in a market, you have to upgrade yourself and to make more money, then probably you can still go ahead understanding and risk as well as the plus points of the refractive market. So in practice, you have to calculate how much population is existing in your area, what population you are catering to, what is your cataract practice, what are the, say, number of IOL or say high-end surgeries you are doing, and how many refractive surgery centers are already there in your area. Again, you have to consider the socio-economic state. Going by the budgeting approximately, which again say Dr. Goktev is going to cover, but the average space required for LASIK machine and diagnostic anywhere ranges between 600 square foot to 1,000 square foot. Maybe then the choice remains whether to own it or rental interior works. Again, the accessories like air conditioners, dehumidifier, and other accessories are cost of LASIK machine. Average cost of new LASIK machine anyway will cost you around 2.5 to 3 crore. Again, a microkeratome cost plus the diagnostic, whatever you want, right from any topography to any high-end pentacam. Even refurbished machine you can think of, but it has its own pros and cons. In spite of investing this much, you have a blade cost ranging from 3,000 to 4,000, general consumable cost required for the surgery, and some machines have a treatment card. Most of the sophisticated machine you go for has a treatment card for their customized treatment. So you have to take into consideration all these areas. Thereafter, additional burden of 5 to 6 lakhs per annum is the AMC or CMC cost. You have to keep in mind the wear and tear of microkeratome. Simultaneously, refractive is the market where you have to consider or think of marketing yourself and your center for that, staff salaries. So one, considering all these, one has to think, what is my basic cataract practice? How much niche IOL I am doing? What is my average cataract surgery? How much I can incorporate from my cataract surgery to refractive surgery in my initial stage. Many companies, they do lens bundling so that to bring the cost down of that basic package or basic machine. And lesser native market as good patient base, if already is there, this again, the marketing cost depends upon how much other LASIK machines are there in your area. So matter of debate whether to do individual or partnership, probably that thing is going to get discussed in later session again. So yes, there are advantages of partnership, so that your liabilities are shared, you can achieve a certain number of cases and everything. But simultaneously, that rapport, that thing has to be there. You should have a good understanding amongst the partner and everything. Sources, again, you can think of your own investment. Many a times you get equipments on deferred payment basis, or you can look for investor partner or a bank loan. But normally in my course, I would suggest not to go for bank loan, because that's a certain liability which cannot be withdrawn at any moment of time. Group of doctor investing together is a very decent proposal, provided you have a good terms and understanding. So when you try to invest wisely into technology, you have to actually calculate the core area of your practice, socioeconomic status of your patient, right? I already mentioned about it, target area, and expectations. If you are doing a reasonable practice where the decent niche, where the criteria or expectations of your patients are not like sick or something, you are doing average number of cases, the patient's requirement are not for any professional reason, even a refurbished machine can service well. Commercial feasibility for refractive market, definitely you have to look into, because expectations and ROI you have to calculate, as well as you have to take into consideration the considerable feasible shelf life of the machine. Any machine, new machine, we consider as a life of 10 years for that machine. If you're buying a refurbished, take into consideration all the maintenance cost after, say, 1,000 days of the equipment. Your core practice, if you are essentially a refractive surgeon and you want to upgrade yourself, you are doing reasonable number of cases at other centers, yes, I would suggest you to go for new equipment. And like a new dimension, presbyopia added to many of the equipment, where you can provide this or you can open this section to the community, whereby you can provide these sophisticated surgeries to your patient, and your patient base can be increased. Patient capacity, paying capacity of your patient, on an average, it depends upon all your practice, what kind of practice you are into, and patient's essential requirement. If you are thinking to cater the patient where they have a huge professional requirement of 6-6 vision, I would suggest 100% go for the new equipment and upgraded technology. You can always opt for refurbished machines to start up, but yes, I do have my reservation about that thing, going by my experience into it. Target area, again, you have to have good volume to survive, to have a, say, feasible proposal. Based on your volume, try and get more sophisticated equipment. On an average, one has to keep this in mind. You have to have 30 patients average per month to have a break-even in refractive practices. New versus refurbished, it's a part of debate, but I do have my opinion. As I mentioned, I have my own reservations against the refurbished machine. Latest technology, yes, a decent outcome you can expect. The machine is well covered under CMC, so you need not bother about the other expenses for at least 3 to 5 years. Sustainability to competition, you can market yourself very well in this. Ace over the others, yes, you can talk that you have the best of the technology many a times, but not to forget that you have to market yourself and not the machine. And emotional high, being a refractive surgeon, if you are doing a good number of cases, you always feel you should have the best with you. Probably Dr. Rohit sir, you will agree with me on that. But simultaneously, you have to calculate the feasibility of that proposal. So this is how I would suggest to initiate. I would again invite Dr. Rohit Shetty to share his experience regarding corporate or, say, company tie-up or getting associated with the refractive business. Thank you very much.